like a sylph vanishing into the wings of a stage. Each moment is devouring some portion of that delight which is granted to every man for his season of existence.
out in a melancholy waltz, the slow sensual turning. The sky is sad and beautiful, like a vast autumn. The violin trembles like a wounded heart, a tender heart that hates the huge black void. The sky is sad and beautiful, like a vast altar. The sun lies drowned in its congealed blood. A tender heart that hates the huge black void is scattered from the luminous past. Dreams remain. The sun is drowned in its congealing blood. And like a glowing moth, your memory shines in me.
Thank you. Late autumns, winters, springtime steeped in mud. Oh, drowsy seasons I love, and I praise you for enfolding my heart and my brain in a misty shroud, a cloudy tomb. In this great plain, where the cold south wind plays, where through the long night the weathercock shrieks himself hoarse, my soul, far better than in the days of warm renewal, will spread wide its raven's wings. No thing is more dear to my chilled and gloomy heart, O dismal seasons, queens of our sad climate, than the changeless aspect of your pale shadows, unless it be on a moonless night, two by two, to lay our suffering to sleep on a perilous bed.
Absolutely good.
His tone. But whether his voice is mild or vexed, it is always rich and deep. That is his special talent and his charm. This voice which whirls and seeps down into the depths of my being, expands in me like a harmonious verse and delights me like a magic filter. It soothes the cruelest sufferings and is filled with every ecstasy. It needs no language to capture the deepest meanings. There is no bow that can sweep my heart, the perfect instrument more richly drawing song from even its most sensitive string than your voice, O mysterious strange cat, in whom everything, as in an angel, is as subtle as it is harmonious. From his blonde and brown fur comes a perfume so sweet that one night I was caught in its ball by having caressed it once, only once. He is the familiar spirit of the house, judging, presiding, inspiring all things within his empire. Is he magician or God? When my eyes are drawn as by a magnet toward my beloved cat, and I obediently look upon him, I look into myself, and I am amazed to see the fire of his pale pupils, bright lamps, living opals, hypnotically fixed on me.
When the low, heavy sky weighs like a lid on the spirit, aching for the light, and when, embracing the horizon, it pours on us a black day which is sadder than any night. When the earth is turned into a dripping dungeon in which hope, like a bat, flutters blindly and bruises its timid wing and tender head against the walls and rotted ceilings. When the rain, stretching down its long streaks of water, imitates the bars of an enormous prison, and a silent throng of loathsome spiders come and weave their webs inside our brains. And suddenly the bells swing angrily and hurl their hideous uproar into the sky like a band of wandering spirits who wail relentlessly. And long hearses, without drums or music, move in a slow procession through my soul, and defeated hope bursts into tears, and the fierce tyrant anguish sets his black banner on my bowed head.
Thank you. chastity and shorn of praises. O prince of exile, who has suffered injustice, and who in defeat grows ever stronger, you who know all, great king of the underworld, ancient healer of human anguish, you who even to leopards and accursed outcasts teach us through passion the taste for paradise. O you who through your old and powerful mistress death begot that charming insanity, you who give the outlaw that serene and haughty smile that damns an entire nation thronging round the guillotine. You who know in what corners of the greedy earth the jealous god hid precious stones. You whose bright eye knows the deep arsenals where slumbers the race of metals. You whose vast hand guards the sleepwalker from the precipice as he strays on the brink of lofty buildings. You who by magic make supple the bones of the old drunkard trampled beneath hoofs of horses. You who to console man in his suffering and weakness taught us to mix saltpeter and sulfur. You who placed your mark, O subtle accomplice, on the forehead of the vile and the pitiless rich. You who turn women's hearts and eyes to the cult of the wounded and the love of rags. Staff of the exiled, lamp of inventors, confessor of the hanged and of the conspirators, adoptive father of those whom in his black rage God the Father drove from the earthly paradise. O Satan, have pity on my long misery.
Thank you. Scattered around it, seals air up. What is it you say, your necklace? Ray, now you're was it, you know, it's in here, we have a lot of and
thank you. me.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go see over the weed.